Hello everybody, my name is Walter, and today I want to show you how you can build a 11-block wide, infinitely expandable floor block shifter and its upgrade, a floor block swapper. So, those are the two things here. The floor block shifter is very simple. You have this 11 wide field, in this case also 11 blocks long, and a single button in this case. And if I press the button, the whole floor shifts one block to the right, and you might notice those positions where the blocks are lowered into the floor actually shift towards the left, so in the opposite direction, as you can see here. So how does this work? Essentially you have a piston tape in here, in the floor, and the blocks are, if I press the button, lowered down, then shifted one block to this, one block around, and then lower, raised it again. And wherever you have transparent blocks down here, the blocks above won't be raised or lowered, and this is essentially how this thing here works. So the blocks are shifted in one direction, and the blocks down here, of course, go in the opposite direction, so the position of those lowered blocks also goes in the opposite direction. So this is essentially how this thing here works. The floor block swapper works exactly the same. The only difference here is this thing here only shifts one block, and this here completely exchanges the floor. So if I press this button here, this nice and neat floor here gets retracted, and after a moment it gets pushed back into the ceiling. And as you can see, there are some transparent blocks in here, which means that some of those blocks here will not be raised actually. And well, as you can see, here seems to be a little game going on. As you can see, you can actually hide by using transparent blocks and full blocks that have the same top texture. Now you can actually hide reliefs and similar things here. So anyway, this is generally how this thing here works. Now let's talk about the size. Both have the same size requirements, since they are essentially the same. This thing here only has a slight modification to the first module and to the control circuit. So, as you can see, it's a modular design. Each module needs one block of length extra. So, this means the total length is the number of blocks, or the length of this segment at the back here, plus 2. The total width is 18 blocks, so the 11 blocks in the middle, 3 on one side, 4 on the other, and the height is in total 7 blocks. I'm not counting this redstone line here, since it's essentially just relocating this button down here to up here, and part of the actual circuit. So, anyway, next to the resources, for the floor block swapper, you will need for the control circuits some building blocks, then 2 glowstone blocks, 9 redstone dust, 16 repeaters, 6 repeaters, 1 comparator, 10 observers, 2 pistons and 2 steel pistons, a single hopper and a button, and a single cauldron filled with water. And then for each module you will need 24 blocks. 11 of those are the first side, another 11 are the second side, and then you have 2 more that separate those two sides and are never really visible. Then 3 normal pistons, 16 sticky pistons, 2 repeaters, and a half stack of observers. And one of those repeaters can actually be replaced by an observer if you want to reduce the lag, although it increases a bit the costs of it, or at least of the nether quartz. So anyway, for the shifter you will need for the control circuit again some building blocks, then 8 redstone dusts, 3 repeaters, 6 observers, 2 normal pistons, a single sticky piston and a button. And the modules are exactly the same, so some building blocks, then 24 normal blocks that are in the piston tape, 3 pistons, 16 sticky pistons, 2 repeaters, half a stack of observers, and again one of those can be an observer instead. And that's all you're gonna need. So next step is showing you how to build first the shifter and then how to modify it to turn it into a block swapper. Okay, so I would recommend starting with building one module. For this, start with the 11 blocks that are here at the top. Those blocks are in the end position, which is essentially inside of the floor. Then with a one height gap below it you have the sticky pistons, and with another one height gap, you have those observer chains here with the branches or the off branching observers there, which essentially so the blocks in between here can power those sticky pistons in the middle. Then on one side you have directly next to this observer chain a non-sticky double piston extender, so at the bottom you have a sticky piston and a non-sticky piston. Then you have a repeater on vortex running into the sticky piston. An observer is observing this repeater and powering the block above it. Another observer is powering the block behind the repeater. On top of the observer is another repeater. This repeater can be replaced essentially by a observer going in the same direction. Then on top you have another observer powering this block, and through that this non-sticky piston there. Essentially what this part here does is it takes a block from here, moves it upwards and then inwards. And on the second side we have a similar contraption which essentially takes a block from up here, moves it down and then inwards. The whole thing is pretty simple. You have a double sticky piston extender with a block below it, which is powered through an observer chain with branch observer. Then diagonally the same thing, directly powering another sticky piston with an observer on top, which essentially powers when moved this sticky piston there. And then on top you have a sticky piston and non-sticky piston double piston extender powered through those observers here essentially. And as you can see, the observers are shifted one block towards the front or towards the control circuit for each module. So in the last module you will have to keep this in mind or you would waste some resources. So anyway, this is one module done, and the next step is essentially building the shifter. And if you want to go further, then you can rather simply modify the shifter into an automatic floor block swapper. And how to do this, I will show you right next. So now, after you've built the first module, it's time to start building the shifter. And for this, let's go to this smaller side here that moves the block upwards. First, place a non-sticky piston right next to the sticky piston down there. A block behind it, a block diagonally, redstone on top, block on top, repeater running into this repeater or observer chain. Raised block behind it, then two lower blocks to the side, redstone on top, and an observer looking at this gap here, which we can actually already fill to circumvent later problems. Then normal block here, so the observer here can actually power the entire thing here. Next, it's time to go down here and with a one wide gap start placing down 11 blocks. So the last block is right next to this sticky piston there. Then a non-sticky piston facing inwards like so. A block next to it, repeater there on one tick. Sticky piston with a block on top, then redstone dust there. And a button here, this is essentially our input later on. Then grab a few observers and place two facing downwards like that, another facing outwards like so. Then a repeater up here. And slowly put it on four ticks. Now the whole thing here should be in the right configuration again. Otherwise you might have to replace those manually. Then raised block there, lower block below it with redstone on top. Block here, again redstone on top. Then grab an observer facing upwards and then inwards like so. Block here, redstone there, repeat on two ticks on top there. Another one, redstone dust there. And then you will have to replace this block. And that's pretty much the entire thing done. So if now you have those in this configuration, you might want to have replaced them in the correct point. And then it's time to actually fill in the blocks inside here. And this means the 11 blocks at the top, the 11 blocks right in the middle, and then one block on top of this double piston extender here, and one block in front of the normal piston there. And with that done, it's time to give it a try. And that looks good so far. And just for records, one more. And as you can see, the shifter is not working. So if you just wanted the shifter, the next step would be maybe relocating the lever, the button here, and then, of course, building more modules and filling them with a bit more colorful things or whatever you want to use there. And how this looks, I will show you after the next cut, and after that I will show you how you can modify this here into an automatic shifter that completely swaps out, or an automatic block swapper that completely swaps out the entire floor with a single button press. And in the end, after building this thing up a bit, I have got this shifter here. So as you can see, if I press the button, the floor shifts in towards the right, and the position of the blocks that don't get raised into the floor actually shift towards the left, as you can see here. So how does this work? Pretty simple. If you have transparent blocks down at the bottom part of this piston tape here, the blocks above it won't raise, since the redstone pulse from down here won't reach the sticky piston there, so in this case. This means that if you set this thing here up, you will have to be careful and know where the transparent blocks are below, or you just use only full blocks and no transparent blocks, and then you have a flat area. Of course, using transparent blocks here opens a few more possibilities. For example, things like maps with two parts, so maybe some coloring on one part, and the other part is some kind of relief or similar thing, so you can actually hide information that is only really visible if the whole system here is in the right spot. So it's also some kind of puzzle possibility in here. But anyway, this is the shifter. Now I've copied over the control circuit here and the first module to show you how you can modify this and make this into a complete block, floor block swapper. So now to build the floor block swapper, we will need to modify the floor block shifter. And for this, let's start with the very first module here. So as you can see, I have already set this up. So we have 11 blocks at the top, 11 blocks at the bottom, and then those two blocks here marked as glowstone blocks that will never be part of the actual floor and will essentially only shift or switch places every time I press the button, essentially. And for the very first module, we will have to actually place observers in here, facing towards the control circuit. In all other modules, you can use any other block essentially, but no observers, since they would give pulses and would actually confuse the entire thing here a bit. So anyway, once you've done this, it's time to modify the control circuit. First, let's go to this side and remove the block of redstone down there. Then let's replace this block here with glowstone. Next, grab an observer and place it down here, powering this piston there. Then put a hopper on top. This is this side done. Now let's go to this side. First, remove this button down there. Then again, this block of redstone down there. Next, let's grab a block and place it there, raised with redstone on top. Then two more redstone blocks here. Repeat on three ticks there, followed by a comparator in this direction. A block here, followed by two normal blocks there, redstone there and there. Another repeat in this direction on four ticks. Then grab an observer, place it here. Next, it's time to grab a sticky piston again. Then a cauldron on top, filled with water. And that's actually the entire thing done. So now let's quickly put in our button. And essentially, what is our button? Well, this is this piston down here. So let's quickly put a block there and a button here. And all you have to do if you want to relocate the button essentially is run a line of redstone in here. So anyway, let's give it a try. and as you can see, the shifting takes place until this observer here reaches this point, at which the entire thing here will stop. And as you can see, the whole thing has finished. And the final step, of course, again, is relocating the button to somewhere else and building a few more modules and filling them in. And as you might notice, there are some transparent blocks hidden below the surface. So what does this mean? So essentially, every transparent block on this side means that the corresponding block on the opposite side will not be pushed into the floor. And how this looks, you will see in a few moments. Just one more shift. And as you can see, we have a little game going on here. So, anyway, this is essentially how you can build this 11 block wide, infinitely expandable floor block swapper and floor block shifter. I hope you enjoyed this little tutorial, and well, see ya!